There really is nothing arbitrary in the Word of God. Everything is so purposeful. Even in obedience, it's just that's how we can live our best life in Christ Jesus. And that's, of course, first and foremost, how we love the Lord. But even then, it's not, you know, His ways are so much higher that when we love Him in obedience, it just reaps this great harvest. In Colossians 3, since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Hold on. Sorry, I wanted to get the New King James, which I really need to get out of the NIV because I am, no offense to anyone in the NIV, I just personally am trying to, I started there and I've gone through it and through it and through it, and now I want to begin again in the New KJV. So in Colossians 3, New KJV says, if then you were raised with Christ, seek those things which are above where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on the things of this earth. We can't say, you know, we're depressed or anxious when we're not applying this principle. It's a matter of pure, it's between surviving and thriving. There are many people who say they have faith, but they're really just surviving. And then you see believers that are really thriving. It's those who apply every word of God. You know, specifically set your mind on things above. This is all about not focusing on the things of this world. The Lord says, seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all would be added unto us, like all, which is the little, you know, the worldly needs, the worldly concerns, which don't feel little when we magnify them. When we focus on the things of this earth, they get huge until they just weigh on us. You know, it's so wise that we just really set our minds on things above and not on the things of this earth. And then we can really, the Lord, you know, this is the mind of Christ because it's the things of the Spirit. And as we walk Spirit-led with the mind of Christ, everything else seems to just fall in line. It's so easy to get on the hamster wheel of focusing on earthly concerns. And it seems totally contrary. You know, that's the last thing we want to do is take our minds off of our problems sometimes. I don't know why we're like that. The last thing we want to just like, if I look away from this issue, it's just going to be worse, when it's the total opposite. If you look away from the issue and you look to the Lord, then you find that the Lord, as you're dealing with His business, you know, being about His business, as you're spending intentional time with Him, all of a sudden everything gets figured out here on earth. And that's, you know, that's God's plan. So let's be so intentional to truly set our minds on things above. And if we're not, you know, I was talking about reaping and sowing, sowing and reaping in the former video. You know, if we're not sowing into our walks by setting our minds on things above, sowing into our lives by setting our minds on things above, then we should expect, you know, then we should expect to reap what happens when you don't set your mind on things above. When you set your mind on things of this earth, then you should expect that, you know, you're, because what I feel here is like the pride of self-reliance. When we refuse to take our minds off of the things, the concerns of this world, we're saying, no, I need to control it. I've got it. I can do it. I can do it. So then if we sow that attitude, you know, then the Lord's going to say, oh, you got it. Oh, okay. You're your own God. Okay. Then let's see how you can get everything together. And that's not to hurt us. You know, that's to teach us, like, I told you to set your mind on me. I told you to set your mind on heavenly things. I told you, if you seek me first in the kingdom of God and my righteousness, that I'll attend to all your earthly needs. So, you know, you can really put every word of God to test, and maybe not, you know, but it's just that every word of God is just so true. As you set your mind on things above, you're going to see how the Lord, He'll give you ways to handle things on earth. He'll handle them for you. But if we refuse, if we walk in the pride of self-reliance and feel like I have to deal with this myself, I have to do this myself, I have to focus on all these worldly things or they're going to fall apart, then we're going to watch them fall apart because we're not equipped. You know, specifically, since if then you were raised with Christ, if you say you believe, then you'll seek those things which are above where Christ is. Specifically in verse 3, for you died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. you know, this is, it's like an explanation. It's no longer you who live, but Christ through you. So set your mind on things above and not of the earth. Like, do you think that Jesus through you wants to have your mind on the things of this earth? No, you know, we're just trying to be reasonable here with the word, because if we're truly being spirit led, the evidence of that is focusing on the things of the spirit, focusing on heavenly things, if we're truly being spirit led. So let's examine that. Let's examine where our minds are and just, you know, repent and course correct. Allow the Lord to course correct us if in fact we're focusing on the things of this earth, because it's only to our own detriment. The Lord is always, you know, he wants us to walk according to his ways, because that is the best way for us to live.